How's it going, everybody? Welcome back. And today we're going to be getting into the pros and cons of NordVPN and whether or not it could be the right service for you. Now, before we begin, if you guys are interested in NordVPN, you'll find a full review as well as links to pricing and discounts in the description down below. Now, one of my favorite things about NordVPN is the performance itself. And this is all thanks to the NordLynx protocol, which will minimize your drops in speed. As you may know, using a VPN will drop your speed. Typically speaking, it will drop by 20-30%, but with NordLynx, you'll notice that your speed drops will often be between 10-20%, and oftentimes it will even be below 10% if you're connecting to nearby servers. If you're looking for the speed results, the speed test results, you'll find them in the review below. But you can take my word for it, the performance of NordVPN is top-notch. And this is, of course, going to be even better with NordVPN's new 10 gigabyte servers are going to raise the bar for speed, as you can as it says, as this article says here. And I believe this upgrade is coming in 2022. Of course, not all the servers are going to be 10 gigabyte per second servers, but a good portion of these servers will slowly be upgraded to 10 gigabytes per second servers until all the servers are up to that speed. Another huge advantage for NordVPN is that, first of all, the servers run on RAM disks rather than hard drives. And that means with RAM disks, there are no physical hard drives that can store information on these servers. So if one of these servers were to be seized, there won't be any kind of information. And with RAM servers, since there are no hard drives, it'll actually be very difficult to store anything. And whatever little information is stored on the RAM disk drives on these servers will be deleted with every machine reboot, which happens quite often as they maintain the servers. And of course, the NordVPN application itself has been audited multiple times, and it has been proven that the no-logs policy indeed is a no-logs policy with evidence, rather than just claiming that the NordVPN no-log policy is a no-log policy. We actually have proof with Cure53 and PricewaterhouseCoopers, very popular independent auditing companies, auditing the NordVPN application and making sure that it is indeed upholding the no-logs policy as promised. And if you'd like to read these reports for yourself, you'll find multiple reports for the multiple independent audits that took place over the years. Another huge advantage for NordVPN is the fact that it is packed with features. So we're talking, first of all, starting with the ad blocker, and you do have the specialty servers. Now let's go ahead and just disconnect, because if you switch to OpenVPN, you will notice we'll be getting extra specialty servers. So yeah, you've got dedicated IP, double VPN, peer-to-peer, and onion over VPN. Dedicated IP will give you the same IP every time you return to one of these servers. So let's say you pick United States, and you go to this 4971, you will always be getting the same IP address if that's something you're interested in, if you go to these servers, rather than the regular servers, the non-dedicated IP servers, where the IP addresses will keep switching every time you return to one of the servers, even if you return to the same server. A double VPN will route your connection through two servers rather than one for double the security. Onion over VPN will give you access to the dark web without having to use the Tor browser, and peer-to-peer will support peer-to-peer activities if you would like to torrent or engage in any other peer-to-peer based activities. Now, I would recommend just sticking with the NordLynx protocol. It is definitely the fastest. You will lose access to a couple of specialty servers like Tor or Onion over VPN, as well as dedicated IP. But if you're fine with that and you don't use these specialty servers, then I would definitely just recommend that you stick to NordLynx. And of course, you'll also be getting an internet kill switch, a conventional kill switch, as well as an app kill switch. You'll be getting split tunneling, and you will be getting custom DNS, which is an easy way to change your DNS, as well as obfuscated servers if you're in a censorship heavy country. And to just explain these very quickly. An internet kill switch will disable your internet and cut the connection if the VPN disconnects unexpectedly. This will make sure you won't get any of your information leaked, and you'll only be connected to the internet while you're secured by the VPN. Split tunneling will allow you to choose which applications are routed through the VPN and which are not, so this can be a very useful feature for a lot of you guys. And with regards to features, that will be it. Obviously, you have over 5,200 servers in 60 countries, which is massive, and it will also help you with streaming. Another advantage of NordVPN is, of course, streaming. You'll be able to unblock up to 10 Netflix libraries, and this is obviously one of the biggest reasons that NordVPN is actually popular. It's because of its streaming capabilities. It is able to unblock so many streaming services. And by the way, if it doesn't work, all you have to do, let's say you're trying to unblock the US Netflix, all you have to do is just try out a bunch of other servers. So if you go down to the United States, all you need to do is just try out some other locations. Let's say the New York location doesn't work. You can try out other New York servers, or you can just switch locations and try other states perhaps. Or you can just go to the 24/7 live chat support and ask them for the best servers to unblock US Netflix. Unfortunately, because Netflix is constantly cracking down on VPN servers, sometimes some of these servers no longer work for Netflix and you have to use some other server that is also optimized for unblocking streaming services. NordVPN works perfectly fine with BBC iPlayer, Amazon Prime, about 10 Netflix libraries, as I mentioned earlier, Hulu, Disney Plus, and whatnot. So yeah, most streaming services will work, at least most of the highly demanded streaming services will work perfectly fine with NordVPN. Now, I talked about the pros. One of the cons is, unfortunately, you will only get a 7-day free trial on Android. So if you're looking to try out NordVPN, you won't be able to try it out completely for free unless you have an Android device. So yeah, Mac users, unfortunately, will still get the short end of the stick, because on Mac, you won't be getting split tunneling. So that's another con, is that you'll be missing some features if you're on Mac, unfortunately. But if you don't need split tunneling, then, well, you're good to go anyways if you don't use such a feature. Though fret not, you can try out the service for free, technically for free, if you go get the refund before the 30th day. You can just contact the live chat support and you'll be able to ask for your refund, since there is a 30-day money-back guarantee with all of the plans. So no matter which plan you get, you'll be able to claim yourself a refund, granted you ask for it before the 30th day. So that is just great. And if you're looking for a discount, again, you'll find a link in the description down below if you'd like to claim the discount, which will give you an extra month, which is always nice, especially after the 2 years are done. If you grab the 2-year plan, you'll notice that that extra month is going to kick in just when you need it. So if you guys are interested in NordVPN, you'll find that link in the description down below, which will give you an extra month. And if you'd like to learn more about NordVPN, you'll find a full review in the description as well. So be sure to check that out if you guys are interested in learning more about the privacy policy, speed streaming, torrenting capabilities, as well as security and features. Comment below if you have any questions. I'll be happy to answer all of them. Like and subscribe if you'd like to support the channel and stay up to date with everything VPNs and cybersecurity. Thank you guys very much for watching. I'll see you in the next one. Have a wonderful day.